Be the glory. Yeah.
Chapter number 20, reading from verses 17 through 38, the New International Version. From Miletus, Paul sent to Ephesus for the elders of the church. When they arrived, he said to them, "You know how I lived the whole time I was with you. From the first day I came into the province of Asia, I served the Lord with great humility and with tears and in the midst of severe testing by the plots of my Jewish opponents. 20. You know that I have not hesitated to preach anything that would be helpful to you, but have taught you publicly and from house to house. I have declared to both Jews and Greeks that they must turn to God in repentance and have faith in our Lord Jesus. And now, compelled by the Spirit, I'm going to Jerusalem, not knowing what will happen to me there. I only know that in every city, the Holy Spirit warns me that prison and hardships are facing me. However, I consider my life worth nothing to me. My only aim is to finish the race and complete the task the Lord Jesus has given me, the task of testifying to the good news of God's grace. 25. Now I know that none of you among whom I have gone about preaching the kingdom will ever see me again. Therefore, I declare to you today that I am innocent of the blood of any of you, for I have not hesitated to proclaim to you the whole will of God. Keep watch over yourselves and all the flock of which the Holy Spirit has made you overseers. Be shepherds of the church of God, which he bought with his own blood. I know that after I leave, savage wolves will come in among you and will not spare the flock. Even from your own number, men will arise and distort the truth in order to draw away disciples after them. So be on your guard. Remember that for 3 years, I never stopped warning each of you night and day with tears. Now I commit you to God and to the word of his grace, which can build you up and give you an inheritance among all those who are sanctified. I have not coveted anyone's silver or gold or clothing. You yourselves know that these hands of mine have supplied my needs and the needs of my companions. 35. In everything I did, I showed you that by this kind of hard work, we must help the weak, remembering the words of the Lord Jesus himself said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. When Paul had finished speaking, he knelt down with all of them and prayed. They all wept as they embraced him and kissed him. What grieved them most was his statement that they would never see his face again. Then they accompanied him to the ship. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Pamacho, Yakin Kansamano, ye every asumafu enuma, iti edio no, chichemudun son copem, ediasan enwacheno, asumafu enuma, iti edio no, chichemudun son ecopem ediasan wachi, Yakin free asanti chi. Nansu o free melito, smako efiso kofre asafu numum penifuono. Wobaye no wakachire won se. Mwaran mun nim. Senye fri die di kanya me ba Asia mantemuno. Metina mun chen sabre nu nyina. Na me de ahumbra siya jine ke siye eni ni suo. Eni sofia etu mien esani se. Yuda fuo bo me hupo pi no sum erade. Na manfadiye mfasuo wosua esese me kachire mu. Ne chire a esese me chire chire mu. Bedjem any fear no mubiara and camemo. Nemum me di o yankupon fem adren sacra, and ne yen radi yesu Christo mu jidie hon a dance ye fico fico echre, juda for any hila for enyena. Afe she, hon homono ashemi, ama me ko Jerusalem. E wumuse me nimunye ebeto me ewo hodie, nanso. Enwara ne se kro biara mu no honhom kronkron no koso di me adanse se mpochire ene ahohiahia eretwan me nanso me kra ho inhia me pi se wie a me wie mamirika tuo ene osom adwuma me nya firi Awurade Yesu Kristo ho se minni Onyankopon adom ho asempa no ho adanse fiko fiko eno afa ehwe minnim se mwa meka ahinye no ho asem ewo mumu no nyina renhu menimu ebiu enti miyimu adansefo enede yi se me ho afi nipa nyina emoja ho ifri se mamfa onyankopon agina to biara anka memo mumu mwenni mmra mo ho ene enwanku a honhom kronkron no ayimu ahwefo wo won mu no enyina eso se monhwe onyankopon asafo a ode onuara ne ba emoja etoye no so ye minim se mekoye achi no mpeteku pone ebehyane mumu a worenye enwankru no brebre na mwara mumu ena emerima ebesore akasa achinchim ensem de atwe esuafo edi won achi enti monwen na monkai se mfie miensan ye ewia ne anajo menya ise mede nisuo ebetu mumu biara efo afei mede moshe onyankopon ene asemo afri na dumumu no ase asemo ebetumi ahye moden na amamo anya ejapade wo won a wate won ho nyina enumo meni emre obiara dwete anasika ana atade mora munnim se mensei ena ama me ene wonga woka me ho no anya nea yehia madano edi a kire mo ade nyina mu se etwa se mu ye dwumaden sa ede bua wonga wo ye mre no na esese mo kai asem awurade yesu kristo no ara kan ye no se omamu ewo enigie pi sene ogie mo yenka amen wo he na okase wie ye no ono oni won nyina bu nkotodwe bompa ye no kure no won nyina su ye Now was so Paul come mu fi na no. If we say as some of kind say worry who no be no year 1 year ye. Inti oja no kwan de no kotena e shen no emu amen.
Monto Yehova wa kwa honyo se
Ah, Ani. all your works, O Lord. We worship you, O Lord. We worship you, O Lord. We praise your holy name, O God. We give you all glory. We give you all glory. Thou alone, our God, thou alone, our worthy. Manzi randele brosaya nana malufi bate na luri endilia nana. We worship your holy name, O God. We praise your holy name, O Lord. We exalt your holy name, O Lord. Praises, O Lord, we sing unto you. All the earth will sing your praise. All the earth will sing your praise. For you alone are the awesome God. Your works alone are awesome. We give you worship, O God, this morning. Maluzi badele brokoto yololobo. Ina mande lura mazakaya danana babaya. Miriana nino zokaya beri.
Almighty and everlasting Father, there is none comparable to you. You alone are awesome. Your works are wonderful. Your church will lift up our voices and say, praise to you only. There is none worthy of our praise this morning. There is none, O God.
Shown himself up once again in our sacred camp and brought satisfaction to all. Jehovah, captain of our hosts, we bow to you. Jehovah, captain of our hosts, we praise your name, Jehovah. Shown himself up once again in our sacred camp and brought satisfaction to all. Jehovah, captain of our hosts, we bow to you. Jehovah, captain of our hosts, yeah, we praise your Jehovah, Jehovah, captain of our hosts. We praise your name, Jehovah, captain of our hosts. We bow, oh Jehovah, captain of our hosts. We praise your name. Jehovah, captain of our hosts, we bow to you. Where you, where you, where the attribute, where you, Rabbi Mo, Amako, many natural. Jehovah, dom so safo hene. Yehovah, drum so sa for him. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Nyamia wo ye kwanche refo pa Treyen kwan wo brasari so Diye nim diye chipo ye ho bai Nyami ho ho me Treyen kwan da Oh Nyamia wo ye kwanche refo pa Ye Treyen kwan wo brasari sari so
is coming to you from the Church of Pentecost, USA, and specifically at Bronze Central Church Building. Amen. And I'm continuing with the series, Being Obedient to God Under the Cloud. Being obedient to God under the cloud. Hallelujah. And I'm going to end the session today with the subtitle, The Cloud and the Church. The Cloud and the Church. Two passages have been our key passages from the Bible. The first one is from 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 10 to 12. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 10 to 12. There you realize that Peter was telling the people that it was the spirit of Christ in the old prophets that predicted about the Messiah who was coming and the suffering that he would go through and the work that he would do. And that those people were not prophesying about themselves, but they were prophesying about us. We, those people who have seen or acknowledge Jesus as our Lord and begin to proclaim the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Now, what we learned from that passage is that people still need the Holy Spirit to do the work of God. If the people of the Old Testament needed the Spirit of Christ in order for them to do the work of God at that time, then we also need that same Spirit of Christ. So you cannot be a follower of Christ, you cannot be a believer, a Christian, without having the Spirit of Christ in you. And the Spirit of Christ we are talking about is the Holy Spirit. So you can only do the work of God with the Holy Spirit in you. So put this one at the back of your mind. And then the second passage that we use that was a key to all the series is 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 1 to 13. I would like us to read that passage. 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 1 to 13. I am reading from the English Standard Version. For I do not want you to become unaware, brothers, that our fathers were under the cloud and all passed through the sea, and all were baptized into Moses in the cloud and in the sea, and all ate the same spiritual food, and all drank the same spiritual drink. For they drank from the spiritual rock that followed them. And that rock was Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. Anytime I read this passage, I'm excited. The spiritual rock that followed them. So the rock was mobile, following the people of God. And then the people of God drank from that rock. And then he explains to us that that rock is Christ. It's wonderful. Nevertheless, with most of them, God was not pleased, for they were overthrown in the wilderness. Now these things took place as examples for us, that we might not desire evil as they did. Do not be idolaters, as some of them were, as it is written. The people sat down to eat and drink and rose up to play. We must not indulge in sexual immorality, as some of them did. And 23,000 fell in a single day. May the Lord God Almighty be merciful to us. We must not put Christ to the test, as some of them did, and were destroyed by the serpents, nor grumbled, as some of them did, and were destroyed by the destroyer. Now these things happened to them as an example, but they were written down for our instruction, on whom the end of ages has come. Therefore, let anyone who thinks that he stands take heed lest he fall. No temptation has overtaken you that is not common to man. God is faithful, and he will not let you be tempted beyond your ability. But with the temptation, he will also provide a way of escape that you may be able to endure it. Amen. This passage is very, very illuminative, very, very insightful. You realize that Paul recounts the story of the people of Israel and how God delivered them. But unfortunately, he also tells us that most of them were disobedient to God, although they witnessed the mighty hand of God in their lives. And Paul explained three special experiences that happened on the way. He brought two of them here. And I'll begin with the first one that is not mentioned here directly. That is the deliverance of the people of Israel through the application of the blood on the doorpost. God delivered them through the application of the blood. God had condemned all firstborn on the land of Egypt, including the firstborn of the people of Israel. But God granted special grace to the people of Israel that if they would apply the blood of a lamb that they should kill on their doorposts, when the angel of death passes by, the angel would pass by and wouldn't enter into the house and kill the firstborns. So all those people who were obedient and then stay within their homes and apply the blood on the door were saved. They were not saved because of their goodness. They were not saved because of their righteousness. But they were saved because of the faith they had in God through the application of the blood. If you compare it to Christianity, we are saved by faith and by nothingness. And then the second thing that Paul brings here is that all of them were baptized in the cloud and in the sea. So when the people of Israel left Egypt and went through the wilderness to the Red Sea, Paul says that when the sea was divided and they passed through, it was a sort of baptism into Moses that the people had. And baptism is very, very important in the Christian experience. If you compare it to them, it's a sign to the world that you are dead with Christ, you have been buried with Christ, and you have resurrected with Christ. And indeed, you have also ascended with Christ. So even as Christ sits at the right hand of all power in the heavens, you are in him there. And therefore, you are no ordinary person. Baptism is an external symbol explaining what had taken place already inwardly in you. Once you acknowledge Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior, you are saved. Once you are saved, you come out to be baptized as an outward symbol of what has taken place already inwardly. Therefore, I've explained that baptism is very important. And the third thing he mentioned here is the baptism in the clouds. When the people of Israel left Egypt, God appeared in a special way. During the day, he appeared like a cloud, like a smoke. And people could see that one visibly. And that cloud also appeared like fire at night. So at night, that cloud of pillar would turn into a fire of pillar. And the cloud directed the people of Israel wherever they went through the wilderness. Whenever the cloud lifted up, the people of Israel had to follow the cloud. And the cloud was what I treated throughout the series, saying that we have to be obedient to God under the cloud. The cloud was representing the visible presence of God in the lives of the people of Israel. That is the cloud. We do not have that cloud in a visible form, But we have the Holy Spirit who represents God in us. The Holy Spirit lives in us. And once the Holy Spirit lives in us, the cloud lives in us. And our advantage is that with the people of Israel, the cloud was different. It was something that was there outwardly. But if you come to the church, the Holy Spirit has come to stay in us. In fact, if you follow the series, you realize that the people of Israel had to go to Moses and ask Moses to intercede for them, inquire of the Lord for them. But if you come to the Christian, the Holy Spirit is already in us. And as we pray, and with the Pentecostals and speak in tongues, the Holy Spirit intercedes for us with words that are sometimes even not visible to us. But even as you are praying, you may be interceding for somebody. That is wonderful. So we have the special advantage of having the cloud in us, that fire in us. And that is why on the day of Pentecost, the Holy Spirit had to descend and fell on the heads of the disciples who were around and then got into them. As the fire got into them, they started speaking in tongues as a sign that the fire had touched the heart. That is the new covenant, the advantage that we have. The people of Israel had the advantage of the cloud leading them, directing them, protecting them. But unfortunately, they disobeyed the Lord. Praise the Lord. At this juncture, we are going to induct Apostle Michael Agyemang-Amoako as the national head of the church in the United States. So shall I invite Apostle Amoako now alone to come and stand here. You can stand here and then face me. All right. You can go a bit. Praise the Lord. Shall I request that everybody be silent now? And also that we try to minimize coming forward here as much as possible. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, and on behalf of the Executive Council, the General Council, and the entire Council, and the entire membership of the Church of Pentecost, I congratulate you on your appointment to this high office of trust as the national head of the Church of Pentecost in United States of America. The General Council would, however, like you to know that acceptance of the office of the national head of the church places upon you the following responsibilities which you must discharge in faith, hope, and love. That you, Apostle Michael Agyemang-Amoako, shall be the national head of the Church of Pentecost in United States of America and work under the General Council of the Church of Pentecost with its headquarters in Accra, Ghana. That you shall be responsible to the chairman through the missions board for the administration of the Church of Pentecost in the United States of America. That you shall report to the General Council every half year and annually. That you shall be responsible to the missions board for all correspondence pertaining to the Church of Pentecost in the United States of America. That you shall, by virtue of your office, be an ex officio member of all committees in USA. That you shall represent the church in all matters relating to the government. That you shall organize seminars, conventions, crusades, rallies, and also retreats for training ministers and other officers of the Church of Pentecost, that you shall implement decisions of the General Council and perform such other functions and duties as may be directed by the Chairman, Missions Board, and the Executive Council. Now, Apostle Michael Agyemang-Amoako, I call upon you to affirm the following. Having fully understood the responsibilities that go with the office of National Head of the Church of Pentecost, do you accept the office? If you do, say, yes, I do, the Lord being my helper.
Yes, I do, the Lord being my helper.
Do you pledge to uphold the tenets, doctrines, and practices of the Church of Pentecost and to work within the framework of the Constitution of the Church? If you do, say, yes, I do, the Lord being my helper.
Yes, I do, the Lord being my helper.
Do you promise to execute your duties to God, to the General Council, the Executive Council, the National Council, and the Church without let, hindrance, fear, favor, or ill will, and to be fair to all, irrespective of social status, gender, and cultural background? If you do, say, yes, I do, the Lord being my helper.
Yes, I do, the Lord being my helper.
But mark this, there will be terrible times in the last days. People will be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, boastful, proud, abusive, disobedient to their parents, ungrateful, unholy, without life, unforgiving, slanderous, without self-control, brutal, not lovers of the good, treacherous, rash, conceited, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God, having a form of godliness but denying its power, have nothing to do with them. Amen. Shall I invite the wife Sheila and the children to join him at this time, as I invite all apostles to join me together with very Reverend from Paul Manson to go and pray for him. Abide under his anointing. Abide under his control. Abide under his anointed. His presence shall out of us upon your soul. Just stay in the arms of Jesus, and I shall be fully whole. Under his anointing. Abide under his control.
Shall all of us pray for them? Shall we pray? Lombri and
Oh God, to live
them to direct them. Morianda la.
Inda la.
Justice
in the house of Jesus, and thou shall be fully whole.
Oh,
abide under his anointing. Abide under his control.
Shall we request Prophet James Oseaminiampo to pray?
Father God, we ascribe all glory, honor, praise, dominion to you. You reign supreme, and you are sovereign. Indeed, you are sovereign. We want to thank you for your sovereignty. And we want to thank you for how far you have brought this church.
Amen.
You have established it here. So may your name be praised.
Amen.
And at this moment, O God, as you have chosen your servant to stand in between the gap and to close the gap and be a security for this church, it is our cry that, Lord, you grant him your spirit.
Amen.
You grant him favor.
Amen.
Favor to shake. Shake systems.
Amen.
To shake ideas.
Amen.
And pave a way for him.
Amen.
Grant him success.
Amen.
Even as your servants lay hands on him, we pray that, Lord, you cause all his weaknesses to diminish.
Amen.
And that, Father God, as hands have been laid on him, you grant him grace.
Amen.
That, Father God, you will determine his steps, that you would let favor show him the way.
Amen.
It is our cry that, Lord, you will speak and minister to him. Be light. And that, Father God, don't let there be any darkness on his path.
Yes.
And as this day he's been established, that he will lead this church for the next period, as you will determine, grant him word.
Amen.
Grant him power to demonstrate your strength in all endeavors.
Amen.
Let the community, the church, people around see indeed and appreciate your dealings.
Amen.
If there is anything that will impede his progress, as hands are laid on him,
yes, Lord,
let your very presence be with him.
Amen.
And destroy all the plans of the devil. And that in all things, when he looks up to you, let him see you.
Amen.
Let him see you in your light. Let him see you in his way.
Amen.
Let him observe you in all things. And even as he studies your precepts, reveal your mind to him.
Amen.
And that whoever is obedient to whatever leading that you are giving to him will enjoy your favor and grace.
Amen.
We also pray for the wife. That's our cry that, Lord, you grant her the counsel.
Amen.
Counsel for the husband. Counsel for the children. Counsel for the church. It is our prayer that, Lord, you cause her to be a prophetess to the leading of the husband.
Amen.
That, Father God, she will be a party to his development and successes.
Amen.
We as well pray for the children as we lay hands on them, that, Lord, you cause them to excel.
Amen.
Let these children be outstanding, and whoever observes them will give glory to you for the very life that you have endowed them with. And as we pray for grace. We pray for grace to succeed.
Amen.
Father God, let goodness and mercy follow them.
Amen.
Even as they come to you at the streams, Lord, quench their thirst.
Amen.
And quench the thirst of whoever lives under their feet for direction. We trust that you have heard us, for we have prayed in the name of Jesus. Amen.
May the Lord cause you to understand this prophetic prayer that has been given to you, so that his very presence will continue to be with you. Amen. In all your endeavors, in Jesus' name. Amen.
You are the one I need.
Cause me to
national head of the Church of Pentecost in USA, Apostle Michael Agyemang-Amoako, and the wife, Sheila. All right.
Amen.
And their children, may the Lord God Almighty, the God of our fathers and our God, continue to be with you.
Who am I to boast in his presence? Dust and clay. I was made of Adam's seed. I am flesh and blood. I am saved by his grace. It's only grace. It is grace that set us free. It's only grace and purely grace. Amen. Our heartfelt thanks and appreciation first and foremost go to the Sovereign Lord, who saw us from afar through his infinite wisdom that has brought us to this level, giving us the opportunity to be servants of his resources. May the name of the Lord God Almighty be praised. We are most grateful to the International Executive Council, which is under the leadership of Apostle Dr. Opoku Onyina, the chairman, and his wife, Mama Grace, who also is the chairman of this great occasion this morning. Again, we are grateful to Apostle Emmanuel Jesiado, the IMD, and also Apostle Alexander Kumit Labi, the general secretary, for such a great confidence in us and confirming what the Lord has ordaining concerning our lives. We thank God and we appreciate you, Papa, and the international executive. Our heartfelt appreciation once again goes to the immediate past national head, Apostle Dr. Emmanuel and Mrs. Patient Owusu, Papa and Mama, COPUSA. We'll forever be grateful to your leadership, your outstanding qualities that has brought the Church of Pentecost, USA, this far. May God Almighty bless you. Hallelujah. And also to the National Executive Council members, we thank God for your life and we bless the Lord for how far you have supported us even since the very day the announcement came. We thank you for your prayers and we know that you are behind us. Apostle Owusu, you have left a big shoe. A very big shoe behind. And it is going to be difficult to fit in. But we are praying. Oh, hallelujah. Papa, God bless you. God bless you. Once again, our profound gratitude goes to Prophet and Apostle J.O. Amenian Pons and their wives, Mama Gina and Mama Mary. It is our fervent prayer that God Almighty will continue on to be with you. You bought a ticket coming down here because of us. You were here when we were welcomed at Washington, and now you are here again. Whatever you have spent, may God richly bless you. Finally, to my fellow apostles, evangelists, pastors, church leaders, and your spouses, we are aware, as you know, the great work that the previous administration have accomplished. And now the mantle has been passed on to us. There is a challenge that we preserve the legacy and the foundation that our founding fathers have received and given to us to conquer the remaining territories ahead of us in Northern America and beyond, to impact our generation positively by grounding them in the Pentecostal faith and apostolic teachings, Christian principles that will impress on this generation, to uphold policies and core values that will keep discipline in the church, something that has brought this church that far. I therefore humbly request the support of each and every one of you so that together we can meet the numerous challenges and the needs of our members and of our generation. Because if we fail to meet the needs of this generation, a time will come that we will not be needed. Our friends and families, brothers and sisters that travel from far and near because of us to come to this great occasion, we say, may the Lord God Almighty bless you. I know that together we will be able to finish the work of our master for the rest of the days that is ahead of us. May God be our helper, and may God bless you all. Amen.
Now we call our national women's leader, in the person of Mrs. Nana Otio Champong and the assistant, to come and then read the testimony and also present the plaque.
I'm standing on behalf of the National Women's Ministry and giving a testimony on Mrs. Patience Owusu. Ephesians 2:10, for we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do. Amen. Mrs. Patience Owusu, affectionately called by all as Mama Pat, is a godly woman, an accomplished, spirit-filled woman of God, a woman of noble character with a very gentle spirit. We may not have the right words to describe her, but we can sum it all up by saying that Mama Pat is a God-fearing, humble in nature, diligent, gentle, and quiet but firm. Hallelujah. Hardworking, hospitable, relentless in prayer, intercession, vested in the word of God, and what is most admired of her is her calm and quiet spirit, which is indomitable, with an indomitable faith. That is to say calm, yet that does not allow circumstances to dictate the final outcome of her faith. Hallelujah. Mama Pat is very loving and caring. She exhibits the true nature of a woman of substance. She is humble inside out and mindful of her dealings with everyone, irrespective of who they are. She is very respectful and able to relate well with both the young and the old. As Proverbs 31:1-10 describes the virtuous woman, so do we find these qualities in Mama Pat. She opens her mouth with wisdom. She is hardworking and does not eat the bread of idleness. She is clothed with strength and dignity and fear of the Lord. She is filled with empathy, witty, and she is a peacemaker. I said she is a peacemaker. These words exhibit how she deals with conflict constructively. She is a good listener. She constantly strives to look for areas of agreement and common grounds to maintain peace. Mama Pat is very hospitable. We will surely miss her with her different recipes and good food. Hallelujah. She loves to read and is very savvy in technology, which helps her to relate very well with our young ladies. She's always willing to share ideas and new innovations she has learned with others. Mama Patience has left a challenging mark in the lives of all of us, a good reputation that can never be erased. Hallelujah. In ministry, we all can attest to the fact that she attends meetings in the local assemblies, district, region, and national, respectively. Whenever she is invited to a program, she will make it her utmost priority to attend, not considering distance. Mama Pat, you will be remembered for the plethora and inspiring and insightful sermons and teachings you delivered at ministry meetings. One of the sermons that stands out so strong and will forever be remembered is the one entitled Going Deeper. Mama Pat, Udine Wohun Ese. Your name Patience is so who you are. In this, therefore, we find your name as an acronym for the following virtues we discovered true to your nature and person. P, prayerful, peaceful, phenomenal. A, amazing, affable. T, thoughtful, teacher. I, insightful. E, exquisite, encourager. She's really an encourager. Hallelujah.
Everything has been said there already, and we have the same here in your plaque. Therefore, we're presenting this plaque in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. God bless you. Love you.
Praise the Lord. I hereby, on behalf of the National Executive Council, present a testimony on our dear Apostle Dr. Emmanuel Anthony Owusu. Let the elders that rule well be counted worthy of double honor, especially those who labor in the word and doctrine, as quoted 1 Timothy 5:17. Our able national head and chair of the National Executive Council, Apostle Dr. Emmanuel A. Owusu, took over the mantle of leadership for the Church of Pentecost in the United States in the year 2009, the year of our Lord. Shortly after assuming office, he retreated his trust in God for the work ahead and assured the body of leadership of his servant leader approach to kingdom business. In his usual gentle demeanor, one could hardly imagine at the time the volume of work that was going to be accomplished through this great vessel given to the church in the USA. In order to present a candid and concise piece of the life and works of Apostle E.A. Owusu, we will construct and write up into following five areas. Number one, his vision and passion. Number two, leadership style. Number three, word and prayer ministry. And then kingdom expansion, that's church planting philosophy and financial prowess. Vision and passion. Our national head is a man of vision. He was very quick in grasping a deep understanding of the terrain of the church in the USA and constantly explained his vision of outreach, decentralization, growth, and breaking of new grounds. He had a vision that embodied spiritual come physical growth of both individual members of the church and the corporate church in general. He has constantly kept his vision on the table during executive council meetings, national council meetings, and in his charismatic self, he will talk to even the young ones, youth and pensa, about what he intends for them to be doing. His vision and passion recognizes the indispensable role of finances in the running of the church. Thus, his ingenuity in financial issues was demonstrated in the uplifting of the finances of the church to the higher platform of excellency. I didn't hear amen in the house. He has demonstrated a large heart in dealing with many issues in the church and will call for all, including the professionals, to be integrated, involved in their local churches. His passion as the father of a nation is expressed in various forms and shapes and could spend countless hours discussing the mind of the Lord for the church of God. It is therefore not surprising that the church grew up leaps and bounds during his tenure as national head. By the grace of God, we have 171 full-fledged assemblies and 37 able elders were called into full-time ministry to bring the total number of ministers in the USA to 68, including two missionaries. There are 55 districts and 7 regions. To the glory of God, we now have 8 apostles, 1 evangelist to equip the body of Christ thoroughly in this evil times. Exemplary leadership. Yes, indeed, leadership is influence. Apostle Dr. Emmanuel Owusu, by his influence, created an enabling environment that made ministers and church office staff comfortable enough to give the Lord their best. He has a fatherly love behind the scenes in his style of leadership. He will stand up to the play and enforce his mind whenever necessary. His leadership style is affability has made him easily approachable and always positioned to inspire hope in those around him. It is unique that he would always emphasize the strength of people and motivate them to higher heights. His style presents him as a truly empathetic leader whose fatherly heart will not let people down. This skill has endeared him to the hearts of many. The leadership style of Apostle Owusu comes across as unassuming, yet very authentic and transforming. Many lives has been touched with the unflinching support of his able area heads. He has raised an army of new ministers who are breaking new frontiers across the nation. undoubtedly, this could not have happened without the proactive leadership skills of a spiritual father. Teaching and prayer ministry. Apostle Owusu is a man who upholds the true values of Pentecostalism, the word of God and prayer. He has not ceased to rely on this ancient and unchanging weapons of our faith. For the furtherance of the gospel in the United States of America, he ministers the undiluted word of God in every district or region where he visits and will create an environment for intensive and spirit-filled prayers of the saints. His emphasis on teaching people the word of God has contributed largely to the spiritual growth of the membership of the church. We would always say, teach. He will always say, teach them the word. And indeed, the teaching of the word has fed, grounded us, and planted the feet of many on higher pedestal of faith. His passion for prayer has impacted the lives of many ministers and members alike. His zeal that God's people be blessed through prayer has led an emphasis on the National Prayer Conference. The National Prayer Conference, Demolition Week, which has personally got involved monitoring and the activities and encouraging all to give it their best. Consequently, the church has witnessed many dramatic miracles in the area of healings, deliverances, fruitfulness, breakthroughs, and many more stories of changed lives and destinies. When it comes to the kingdom expansion philosophy, our national head has a result-oriented approach to kingdom business. He is astute at checking statistical figures and noting observed growth in various aspects of the work. With his vision for expansion and growth, he would apply his knowledge of the numerical state of the church to his planning and decision making. This careful combination of knowledge and experience has led massive church growth during his tenure as a national head. The planting of new churches, creation of districts and regions prove the incredible grace of God on his church as he led us. The results in the nation speak volumes of what the Lord has done through the undeniably able leadership of his servant. The church has indeed grown by leaps and bounds, giving room for many young ministers today to be given the opportunity to fulfill their calling assignments on earth. Apostle Dr. Anthony Owusu has demonstrated extreme financial prowess in the management of church funds. He is meticulous and frugal when it comes to the usage of God's money. This has marked him out as a faithful steward of God's funds. His profound wisdom in financial matters led the church to undertake very peculiar and growth-assuring financial initiatives. The church has thus saved hundreds of thousands of dollars, which naturally and justifiable would have gone down the drain to the already rich banks, financial institutions, and agents of corporate America. Health insurance has been modified to save extreme cost. Mortgages and loans of church edifices have been bought. You didn't understand that. Backed by the national office saving the church huge sums in interest payable and more. With the support of his able lieutenants, the church has experienced phenomenal financial growth, and this has contributed significantly to the purchase of several great edifices, mission houses, vans, and other notable church properties. The total investments in mortgages bought back stands at 8.4 million capitalized. In conclusion, this faithful day of our Lord, it is written, for God is not unjust. He will not forget you. He will not forget how hard you have worked for him and how you have shown your love to him by caring for other believers as you still do. Hebrews 6:10. The impact of the life and ministry of our ongoing national head, Apostle Dr. Emmanuel Anthony Owusu, on the church in the USA will always speak to posterity. In all of this noble accomplishment, the story will be incomplete without the unflinching support, wisdom, and godly attributes of his beloved wife, Mama Pat. Your family is deeply appreciated, Papa, for your selflessness, dedication, and unflinching stance for the true values of the kingdom. The Lord will surely not forget your labor of love. Ayiko.
I want to also echo for the fact that when our dear apostle came to USA, the membership at that time was 16,000. But as he leaves, the membership stands at 26,000. Put your hands together for the Lord. There was one thing that was mentioned, and probably you did not understand it well. With the finances, when he came here in 2009, our finances was below half a million. But now we have investment over 8 point something million. Church, put your hands together for the Lord. Papa, Aiko, Aiko.
What is written on here, most have been heard. So on behalf of the National Executive Council, I present this plaque to you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Praise the Lord. The testimonies that I've been given on Apostle and Mama are very right. Mama is an example of a pastor's wife. Therefore, there's going to be a global minister's and wife's conference in Ghana in 2017, and she has been requested to present. All right, let me finish there. She has been requested to present a teaching message entitled An Example of Christ as a Minister's Wife. Yeah, that sums up the testimonies that have been given about her. Apostle Dr. Owusu was the first North American to be asked to head a church in USA here, you know, coming from Canada. And she has done it very, very well. You see, sometimes people were saying, why is he not going on transfer? He has kept long here behind the scene. But if a footballer is playing well, the coach does not change him. He was able to stamp away worldliness, focus on Christ, and did what the executive council was expected of him. And therefore, we think that this is the time that he has ended his work in USA here. The executive council appreciates him for doing such a good job. It is our prayer that the Lord God Almighty will continue to lead him, and even as he's representing the executive council in North America here, he will continue to use him. Amen.
Hallelujah. I don't know what to say. I'm short of words for the awesome God that God has done. In fact, I was coming to the USA with a burdened heart. And right now I'm living with a heart full of joy and praises to our living God, who has once again proved himself faithful unto us. Hallelujah. Therefore, I would like to take this opportunity to give him all the glory and the honor that he deserves. Because who are we? Who are we? We don't have any wisdom and we don't have any might. But the God himself has worked miracles through us. And we give him all the praises and the honor. Amen. I would also like to thank our chairman, Apostle Professor Opoku Onyina, and Mama Grace for their unchanging support in every way, their advice, their encouragement, and everything. I don't know what to say. Dear Chair and Mama Grace, I say may the Lord God be with you. Amen. I also thank the IMD, Apostle Jesiado, and our former IMD, my own father-in-law, Apostle S.K. Bedu, who was in the office where we first went to a missionary trip to Paris, France. We also want to thank them so much for what they have done for us. We thank the GS, also past and present, for their support. And all the executive council members, not forgetting all their wives for their support. Hallelujah. I also want to thank Prophet Amenyampo. Prophet Amenyampo is my own brother, he's a rare brother. And since he is my brother, of course, he's a twin. So his twin brother, too, is my brother. And they have become part of us. In fact, both with their wives, they follow us everywhere. And Prophet just came from a conference in Brazil. He just landed this morning around 6 a.m. and now he's here with us. I want to say God really bless them for the love that they have for the family. Amen. I also want to thank Mama Say. He also came this morning all the way from Brazil because of us. Mama, God bless you. I also want to thank the National Executive of USA. In fact, I don't have words. We thank you so much for your support. In fact, we came from Canada. We are not part of you, but you accepted us and you have worked with us. We say God richly bless you. Not forgetting all the area heads and all the ministers and their wives. As of Mami for Nami on Shramo. Say Yesiana Mekan Samoa. Mijina Hoya Manum Ponte. Nasunami can be an omusum na mudi yejuma. God richly bless all of you. Amen. I also thank the women's ministry. I want to thank the men's ministry, youth and pensa, children's ministry, all the ministries. We say thank you and may God richly bless you. We also want to render our sincere thanks to Prophet Amiyao, who came all the way from Ghana. We want to thank Mama Jima. Mama Jima is also part of us. He always with us wherever we are. Mama, God bless you. Prof, God bless you. We also want to thank Evangelist Kenny. In fact, when we met
last November, he told us he will be coming, and the wife, and they are here because of us. Evangelist and wife, God really bless you. There are so much. I hope I don't forget some of you. I mentioned our former IMD, Apostle S.K. Bedu, who is our in-law, and he couldn't make it, but Mama Becky is here with us. In fact, he should have been in Ghana right now, but she decided to wait and be with us for this occasion. Mama Becky, God richly bless you. I also want to thank Bronze Central. This is the assembly where we worship. Amen. And I'm so much grateful to you. All the three presiding elders that we have worked with, you have never left us alone. You are always with us, supporting us in every way. And I thank the first presiding that we met here, Elder Opoku and the wife. I thank you so much. And then Elder Asante and the wife. In fact, the wife, we don't have time, but Chair, please permit me to say this because it has really, really helped me. One time I gave a testimony here about flying and the turbulence that most of the time we experienced and the fear that was in me. After we've closed, Mama Rita came to me and she said, Mama, you know what? I have realized that you are really scared when you fly. I'm going to pray for you, seriously, so that this fear will go away. Hallelujah. And she did it. One time we came back and he said, how is it? And I said, well, right now it's 80%, 20% more. So continue praying. And to the glory of the Lord, right now when I'm flying, there's no more fear. Amen. So we thank you all for what you have done for us. And last but not the least, I also want to thank our family, our children, all our in-laws, and our childhood friends. You have supported us. And you continue to support us. God bless you all for what you have done for us. I want to say this in French because one elder said we have been in France for 6 years and for 7 years now, he hasn't heard us speaking a single French. So I want to say, Que Dieu vous bénisse. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah. Okay, you can, please, family members can sit. Thank you so much for your support. Yeah, church, I don't have words enough to say thank you for everything you have done for us for the past 7 years. In fact, we have labored together. You have prayed for us. You have counseled us. You have given us every support that we needed to make this journey a very successful one. My successor is young. And coincidentally, I'm also young. And I believe Jesus was born on a Thursday. Yeah, it's true. Yeah. So he has no problem with Jesus in him. Now he said, I have left a very big shoe. And I just want to tell him that he has no problem to wear this shoe. I've told people several times, when we're young, Christmas time, your fathers will take you to Bata or Lena's. And when you wear size 4, they will buy you size 6. And then you can put in some papers. And in a couple of months, you grow to it. So, yeah, you don't have a problem. I think I'm the one that has a problem. And that is why the prophecy came. That what you did here is not the same as what you are going to do. The reason is that now I'm going to a place where the size of the shoe is small. And to be able to perform my duty, I should wear that shoe. So how am I getting my feet to that shoe? And that is the issue. When I confronted some people, they told me that you can put the shoe in the freezer, leave it there for a couple of days. And when it begins to melt or defreeze, it will open up. Others were also saying that you can, you know, mesh it in water for a couple of days. And then the third idea, I don't know if I have to cut the size of my feet, get a doctor, you know, to make a surgery. But at all costs, I still have to wear that shoe. And I know God will provide the way. Just as through you, all God help us to do the work here in USA. Once again, I want to thank God so much. He's been very faithful. I was telling people that there wasn't a single Sunday in the 7 years, in spite of our numerous travels, where I was not able to say, go to church, I'm sick. It is all a strength from the Lord. Jet lags did not have any impact on me. And it is all the glory of God. So I tell God, thank you so very much that I'm profitable and a feeble somebody like me should be asked to work here in the United States. And I want to thank our dear Professor Opoku Nyina and the executives at that time, you know, for the confidence they had in me. I'm sure I have not betrayed the trust. Because at that time, they were giants. Who am I? See, with my nature, I'm a very quiet person, unless you are close. And even at church, I wouldn't do anything. It was on one Sunday evening, after I had preached at secondary technical school in Koforodia, and was going home, and church was still in service. And I decided to go there and take the benediction. And as I sat in the pew, at the end of the announcement, Prophet Ameyao called me and said, today we are praying for two people to be made a deacon. He mentioned my name, and I turned to the congregation. Everybody was pointing to me. It's you, it's you. So he called me to deaconship, you know, without interview. Because he knew if you call this guy for an interview, he will never present himself. A week later, when we had a presbytery meeting, he told me, you are going to Ada Assembly to be a presiding leader. An assembly where there is an elder and a deacon is going to preside. It normally doesn't happen in the COP. I can't even offer communion services, but the elder, but yet I have to be the leader. And so on and so forth, you know, it happened up to this time. So, I don't know why God decided, you know, to offer me such a noble task. So, Chair and the executives, I thank you so much, so very much. God richly bless you. And I also want to thank my predecessors from Apostle Amoa, who did a great job here in the USA. He laid a good foundation. And what he laid is what we built on, which has brought the church thus far. I want to thank him and his wife. God richly bless. And I want to thank the office staff from the NAM I met here, John Kudof Ansa. You know, he was my aide-de-camp. And Elder Osei Tutu, my first national deacon. Elder retired Amua was our auditor. And then retired financial manager Elder Day. I want to thank all of them. They all supported me. And I want to thank my great Leonard National Finance Board members and the National Audit Team. We sat down together and they brought their professional acumen to board. And therefore, anything that you bring forth for discussion, they are able to dissect and then make very genuine decision which have brought the church this far. I say, God richly bless you. And I know you will give an unflinching support to my successor. And lastly, I want to thank all of you. All of you. Because every blessed day, I can sense the people of God praying for me. So if anything is accomplished, then we have done it together. You will not see the rewards today from my national executive members to the district, regional executive members to the district executive to the locals. But one day, the Lord God Almighty reward all of you for the secret things you have done on notice. And finally, let me give you just four verses in Philippians chapter 2, verse 1 to 4. Sorry, 4. Don't ever forget this. I'm reading from the American Standard Version. That is what my iPad could pick. I had wanted to read the NIV, but it's okay. If there is therefore any exhortation in Christ, or any consolation of love, if any fellowship of the Spirit, if any tender mercies and compassions, make full my joy that ye be of the same mind, having the same love, being of one accord, of one mind, doing nothing through faction or through vain glory, but in lowliness of mind, each counting other better than himself. Not looking each of you to his own things, but to each of you also to the things of others. Amen. Thank you, and God richly bless you.
Apostle John Osei Ameniam Pontu.
Yendofo ni yenachin kwa pa. Yedena se eni aye ye ema utin kron kron. Utun funya nko pombra uboni, wabawa ye mojatu wana yem, ena usra won isi ese osumafu. Yedo wasi, ni wo nyanko pon afa unkro foso aye, entitia watiti nipama ama ahiniye. Na wana wini muonso abihungo. Na nam wonso, isi nsore dan hudwo ama wasoria. Ye besumu woti asifu nyanko pon ewom. Ni awa ye efe, ijapa ye dawasi. Ebreti simu, ena utu boni se gentia. Efi America, ako Canada. Nyamia wini mungkrofu. Erwade yesra wu. Fawonguro Mununkum Numu, Mununkum Nuni Wankai, Nenye Bambo, Enyen to Madai, Enye Gwansuma Bia, Erade Enfamabo. Baby, I will do on Abisino, Erade Fasha Wansa, Senior Nano Wishi Joshua Bono, Erade Fab Dumo, Muenuma Sem Enyemqua, Muenuma Sem Enyen Nipe Yi. Mwenuma sem emfa oji emfa mri nipamba. Erwade ma wone tifini ni anafo mbesu unsu. Amani yebifri wumu abano. Wona msu aya wangwate. Emro yebi woha. Erwade tafri. Sunsu mkronkron. Bofa wankirasu. Ni imro yene sintu biyara. Nafri saadu yisi yisi wankrofo wakwansu nankoso. Me juma edawo nenim. Yinimise obeye. Emo fresha wansa. Erwade ka wohon. O donsa enda wonso na ye won yie na urade fo na mo sisi yie e ma bone ni how be unto won demo mo wanu nyam no urade entra won krofo so yes ro bi o se urade won krofo ma adwuma okoto aso e wa Canada urade ma enso aba na ma won konim die wo won bere so na ye mfa nu nyam mo kase nyankopon wa ya de kase utie yi nti ye wogidi ni ahoto so se nyame wetie ye And that was what I say with Jesus' name. Amen.
And when Yam Connie Adema and Yameti as a fool, now I can't one while dawning one century and Yaka say away away your home. I really won't want no for Shrow. Yea, you can see. Yea, ma one more away Juma can see away your maho. Ebenezer and Yanko Papa. Nia wodia bedreni yama wa iko
amen
yesrao ye ya wo kese yesu wan monyam ya tontron ya mawo so ya kron
yes lord
ye free he ye free wanim wodom ene ye nko
amen
umurukum enkata ye nso
amen
ye ntena murukum nase
amen
na boya bamba na wo aye
amen
dumuka ye ho
amen
Na fa ye nia wo pe ayenso yen si wan munyam yada wase obi aye kwenyina fa yen ko duro jojo
amen
wa sumdwe nkwaso ntena yenso ya ye wunyame wa pe die yada wase o Kristo Yesu di mu na yabompae amen
amen
you give the glory to Jesus and tell of his love And tell of his love, we give the glory to Jesus. And tell of his wonderful love. And tell of his wonderful love.
Amen.
May he who is far above all things,
Amen.
The Lord God Almighty,
Amen.
The God of our fathers,
Amen.
And our own God, continue to be with his church,
Amen.
And may the church here, even in the United States, continue to grow from glory to glory. And may all the saints here celebrate and enjoy in the Lord and say that this is the doing of the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
And may his glory continue to fall on each one of you. And may his presence, his very presence, his blessings be with you. If you are going out and you are coming in.
Amen.
And may you say that I indeed belong
yes,
to the Lord.
Lord.
And the Lord is my portion. May you go in peace in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Amen.